turn against Stamkos. Scores! Number 60 for Steven Stamkos.
The one thing I know is I'll never be as flamboyant as Graves, and he's got me beat big time on that. I might have gotten more wins, but he deserves a credit in that area, and I'm extremely boring comparing to him.
All right, now let's get... Look, I like that, Julien. You know, I've always said that. I'm new prospect game. I went against the prospect game with him the whole deal. But I never said a word about Boudreaux when he had 250.
I think you did.
No, I didn't.
Anyway, Boudreaux was the quickest to 250 ever. And you didn't whine about that at all?
Wait a minute. I was. Now, let's get it. Listen to this. Listen. Back in the days when I coached, they didn't have shootouts. We had 60 ties. We won 60% of our games, which means it'd be around 40 wins. Have you got that straight?
Follow that completely.
So that means, Bruce, I hate to say you had to win another 40 games, and Julien had to win, a good guy, had to win another 40 games. So let's get that straight.
And he is right. You look sharp tonight. So you have the tough guys love you, and here's a good example before the game, which is really neat. How about Doug Gilmour wearing Hockey Night? Thank you, Doug.
You look good. Well, let's say it.
This is the... little mingling.
There it is. There Beautiful. It is. And you know what I told? Oh, there it is. And here's one of the other guys going along, shaking hands. And there they tell him, you're the +3, leading the league. Says hello to Dougie, too.
Mark Fraser. I did get to talk to Ben Scrivens, at least. But as you say, Mark had the bout. And also, Colton Orr is just an amazing story. So.
Yeah, you're not kidding. And I said to him, I went to him, and I said, John Scott. Who's John Scott? Remember Okay, Odom, go ahead.
So what do you think, Mark Bergevin? I was going to ask Mark if I ever get him on. You know, he dresses fancy, wears costumes. He's the fun of the party. And they've got the fun police at PK Subban. No more
okay,
Mr.
Hold
Personality.
Hold it. You remember when PK, I knew him since he played for the Marlies. I said, stop that stuff, that silly stuff you're doing, jumping around and all that, and giving the high five and that. The players will turn against you. Your own players will turn against you if you don't stop it. And... We first of all, I'll show you how he used to do it. You see, the big thing is, Thierry and Gouvernement played the game. They know what's going on. He stopped that silly stuff. He irritated the other players and all that. Look at the guy waiting there. Like, he's like, get in there, Gilsey. Get on, stop it like that. Now, watch it now. Watch he does it like a sensible like that. That's the way to do it. And I tried to tell him that a few years ago. Stop that silly stuff. Same as I did Ovechkin. The same as I did, you know, the bird and the thing. And you can't do that and expect the players to like you.
That reminds me, Yakupov's goal, the big winner in Phoenix the other night, we didn't put that on the list.
No, I didn't want to put it on, but he went up, hey, come. Okay. I'm just going to leave him alone. He's doing all right. The kid doesn't know. They'll straighten him out, because what you do, you irritate the other players, and you irritate your own players. If you had listened to me 3 years ago, he wouldn't have gone through that stuff. Go ahead.
And the Tampa Lightning are unbelievable, and one of them is a surprise, but Vincent Lecavalier's going, they're amazing.
And Martin St. Louis, but listen, Corey Conacher from Burlington, Ontario, 5'8". This guy is unbelievable. He is something like this. 5 foot. I don't know why Calgary let him go. Remember, he was out there. I did a little thing on him. I have to tell you something. He did it the hard way. He went down in Norfolk. He was an MVP. And you know who he credits all this to? His grandfather said, never quit because he's so small. And Doug Nezel, his coach for the Burlington Cougars, said, never quit because you're too small. And all you kids that are small out there think you're never going to make it. St. Louis and him, too.
Well, here you go again. It's 1 ounce of heart worth a pound of muscle and Jordin TooToo.
I've always said TooToo from Churchill, Manitoba. This guy, K. Howard, he went out and got him. He is the absolute favorite of Detroit fans. They haven't had a guy like this in years. Joey Kosher and guys like that. Look at this guy, and the fans go nuts when he's there. He is the favorite of favorites, and he not only fights, he can score goals and the whole deal, but he does throw them pretty good. And look
That's
at that hit
night,
there.
Man.
That was last night. A favorite of mine all the time.
Roman Polak, the guy he hits, about 240, 2-2 on a roll, and that was a big win for Detroit after they got thrashed by St. Louis. So the New York Islanders...
Now, everybody asks, why are they winning? I'm just going to show you the goaltenders and the coaching is good. I'm going to show you the reason I think they're winning. Two guys, John Tavares and Matt Molson. I see his dad, Matt's dad, at the minor midgets game. Watch that there, little tic-tac-toe. Now, watch, kids. He's a trigger man. Watch his stick down over Bing. Now, watch the next goal. He keeps his stick down. Here it comes out. Bing, in the net. Now, if you had a stick in the air like most of you kids do, see? Bing, in the net. Get your stick down like that. Now, I want to talk about a few things that happened in New York, and a lot of people made fun of it, and people don't understand it. And Callahan hurt his shoulder against Talbot in a fight. We're going to show it here. And people don't understand how a guy could be so concerned about a guy he's trying to beat his brains in. And then all of a sudden, you'll see Callahan say, go, oh, my shoulder. Now watch. He goes down. He says something, my shoulder. And look at Talbot. He gets up and he calls over the trainer. Now, I heard guys on the radio and in the pit make fun of them. They don't understand. The reason they said, we don't understand how a guy could be trying to beat his brains out and call it over. You know why they don't understand? Because they don't understand. They never played the game. This is the honor game. This is a code of hockey players. We're the greatest people in the world, as far as I'm concerned. Now, Teddy Roosevelt said something, those timid souls who will never know victory or defeat. That's those guys that talk, make fun of Talbot. That's the way we are, and we're the best players in the world.
Until you've been in that location or dislocation, Don Cherry in the Coach's Corner on Hockey Night in Canada.
Coach's Corner on CBC. Brought to you by Budweiser. Great times are waiting. Why not grab some Buds?